Consider the following scenario. Let's say you visit a monument and you take a picture. And sometime later, your friend visits the same monument and takes another picture. Now, we, of course, have no idea where these pictures were taken from with respect to each other. But it turns out that if you know the internal parameters of the two cameras, then from these two arbitrary views, you can compute the translation and rotation of one camera with respect to another camera. And once that's done, you can then compute a three-dimensional model of the monument. This is the problem of uncalibrated stereo. But first, let's quickly recap what we have discussed before, which is calibrated stereo or simple stereo. So in simple stereo, we have a left camera, say for instance, and we know everything about this camera in terms of its internal parameters. And then we take a picture of a scene and simply translate this camera along the x-axis to create a right camera, and then take a second picture of the scene. And the translation is by a distance b, we'll call that the baseline, and from these two images, we can compute the three-dimensional structure of the scene. And the principle is triangulation. Let's say that there's a point uv in the left image, then we find the corresponding point in the right image, and we can then shoot out two outgoing rays, and wherever these rays intersect, that's where the physical scene point lies. So this is done by using essentially the perspective projection equations. And so you have the perspective projection equations for the left camera here, where fx, fy, ox, and oy are the internal parameters, which we assume are known to us. And for the right camera, we have exactly the same equations, except that you have x minus b here, where b is the baseline of the stereo system. So since we know fx, fy, ox, oy, and the baseline b, we can use these four equations to solve for x, y, and z, the coordinates of the point in the scene. And of interest to us was this denominator here, ul minus ur, which we call the disparity of the scene point in the two images. So that's simple stereo. We know how to do that. What we are interested in here is the more ambitious problem of uncalibrated stereo. In uncalibrated stereo, we want to develop a method for recovering the three-dimensional structure of a scene from two arbitrary views of the scene. We will assume that the internal parameters of both the cameras are known, and that's often available to us in terms of the meta tag that goes with each image that's captured in modern-day digital cameras. But what we don't know are the rotation and translation of one camera with respect to the other camera. So we'll take a look at the problem of uncalibrated stereo. What is known to us and what needs to be recovered before we can reconstruct the three-dimensional structure of the scene? Well, in order to solve this problem, we actually need to formulate the relationship between, the geometrical relationship between the left and right cameras. And that is very concisely described by what's called epipolar geometry. In particular, epipolar geometry tells us that points in the left and right image are related to each other through a single 3x3 matrix called the fundamental matrix. If we can find the fundamental matrix, we can find the rotation and translation of one camera with respect to the other camera. So the calibration problem boils down to finding the fundamental matrix. So next, we develop a method by using a small number of corresponding points in these two arbitrary views to estimate the fundamental matrix. Once we have that, then we can go ahead and find the rotation and translation, and our uncalibrated stereo system is now fully calibrated. So next, we of course then go ahead and recover the structure of the scene. The first thing to do there is to find dense correspondences between these two images. Ideally, for every point in the left image, we want to know where the corresponding point is in the right image. We show that this boils down to a 1D search in the right image. So once we have these correspondences, we're left with computing depth. And this is a very simple process, and it is a least squares estimation process, and we'll show how that's done. And finally, we'll talk about stereo in nature. We'll look at different animals and how stereo is used, and in particular focus on the human visual system.